Okay, time to go on an adventure.
Caught behind Venetian blinds, out of reach for the city lights. This ain't where I belong. Hey, look at me, man, what I've become. I've been running east, looking for sunset, digging deep since 99. What I thought was gone was sitting in my pocket in plain sight all along. It's time for me to go, burn all bridges. All I know, I got lost along the way, fell between the foam, pulling the stitches. Time to let go, so come what may. Before you leave, what you give you get to keep. So long, farewell, bye-bye. Let's have a toast for those lost old eyes. And my crooked little heart that seems so rebellious is falling apart right.
Hello, adventurers, and welcome back to my channel. Now, if you were paying attention as we kind of did the intro there, we are at a campsite, and we actually just tried out a few of the items that I've been adding to the van. And today, I'm going to be sharing with you why those items are so important to me. Specifically, one item. That fridge that you just saw, game changer. Now, you may remember a few weeks ago, I introduced you to the SetPower AJ40 and told you I was going to be testing it out and then getting back to you guys and giving you my full review on it. SetPower was nice enough to send me this fridge, and so I definitely wanted to give them a full run review before I told you guys what I thought about it. And so today, on one of the hottest days of the year so far, I thought this was the perfect time to really get it out and share with you all of the features and show you what it gives me the ability to do, even in the hottest of conditions. Now, it's been riding around with me in the van for several weeks, and I've been using it to cool my food and do a variety of different things just to kind of test out what I could fit in there, what kind of cooling capacity it has, how much power it actually uses off of my Jackery, and if it really is feasible for me to have the AJ40 while on lengthy road trips. And let me tell you, I've tested it hard and strong, and I've definitely learned a few things about the SetPower. So now I'm going to share those with you. First of all, I don't know if you can hear it or not. Nope, not really any sound. It's pretty quiet, and I really liked that because some of the refrigerators that I was looking at are a little bit more noisy because their compressor kicks on, and when it does, it just In a small space, I couldn't have that happening while I was trying to sleep. That would mess up my sleep. So this thing has been super quiet. Another thing that I noticed was that it's pretty large. If you look inside this thing, you'll notice I can fit a full 2-liter soda inside of it. It is so, so tall. Not to mention, I can load it up with all sorts of other kinds of foods. Now, this isn't the largest that SetPower has, but it's perfect for me because I can put those larger items in there, such as fresh fruits, vegetables, meats, things like that, and keep them cool enough to go down the road. And I've been testing that a lot, and I found out many, many things. Like, for example, inside the lid, there is actually a food type instructions panel that gives you a recommended temperature for each of the items that you might want to put inside. And again, look at this. I have a storage compartment up here that is tall enough for me to put a thing of egg whites and a couple of other things. I also have these two deep baskets that this can actually remove, or you can remove this all together. But look at that. There is a soda in here. That is a full 2-liter soda. And then this is a standard English muffins, and they fit perfectly across. Okay, so if you're looking to find out how large of a space that is, though, get this, measurements, 27.5 by 13.6 by 17.3. No wonder we can fit a soda in there. It's huge. But if you decided that you wanted to use this as a freezer instead of a refrigerator, that's a whole lot of ice cream. Now, I don't need ice cream. I need fresh fruit, fresh veggies, things like that. But, you know, that's just a little tidbit there for you guys at home who might be considering getting one of these and you're wondering if they would actually work for that. Yes, they do. Now, the AJ40 does have an eco and a max mode. This is so that you can either save on your wattage or you can amp it up to get a quick cold condition inside. And trust me, guys, I have tried a variety of different temperatures in this, and I have found that my sweet spot is running it at about 35 degrees. For the things that I personally carry with me. Again, you can reference that chart, and I definitely have been, but 35 degrees seems to work great. And one of the things that I noticed is I had it set at 35 degrees when it was inside the van, and it regulated very well. It didn't really fluctuate a whole lot. When I brought it out into direct sunlight, right here on this table, massive amounts of sun, it did fluctuate a little bit, but that's to be expected. Even then, though, it only got up to about 41 degrees, and that was on eco mode. Now, will I typically be bringing this bad boy out and setting it up on my picnic table? Probably not. I have a perfect spot for it in the van, and it does fit very, very well. Which brings me to my next point. This thing right here actually does have handles, and you can see right here that you can attach handles. I have chosen not to do so because I do leave it stationary in the van, so I don't need to pick it up very often. I did bring it out here though, so you guys can get a little bit of a closer view of what it looks like and how big it really is to make it a little bit easier for me to do the review. One of the things I really liked about this particular refrigerator is that it was so easy to use. I could simply plug it into either AC or DC with one of the components that they have included with the package. And after that, the compressor kicks on and it's just a matter of minutes before I can start cooling my food. And the AJ40 does have a 2-year warranty on the compressor and a 1-year warranty on the other parts. Now, how does it do on power? That's something that I was asking whenever I first was sent this, because I didn't know how well it would go using a portable power station. I do have 1,000 watts, but at the same time, I know that things can quickly start to add up and really drain that battery down. So I was a little worried, but I can say after using it for about a month, I actually am pretty surprised. I can plug it into my Jackery and it only pulls about 55 watts on average. Now, in direct sunlight right now, it's pulling about 67 watts because it's having to work twice as hard, so I have to put it in max mode. However, 67 watts on a 1,000 watt battery still is going to last a really long time. And as long as I'm able to regenerate my battery and have a way for me to charge it, I am A-okay. Now, if I weren't to recharge the battery, it would go for about a day and a half without cutting off. And that's a day and a half also using my laptops, my cell phone, and my cameras on the same Jackery. That's not by itself. Now, you're probably asking yourself why the intro of this video was so long and why I showed so much of the road that we were going down. It's because I wanted you to see all of the bumps and bends and winds and crooks and craziness that we go over on a typical adventure day. And the reason for that is because this guy right here held up to all of it. It actually has an anti-shake technology and you can get it into situations where it's up to like a 30 degree incline without it messing up. Some of the other fridges out there that a lot of people are using, if they get anything past 30, they're gone. They're done. You can't use them anymore. So this is a huge advantage for doing van life and having a fridge, because I'm all the time on some kind of crazy winding road and I need something that can hold up. And this definitely can. So you're probably thinking to yourself, what's wrong with it? What's the catch? Where does the shoe drop? Something. There is no catch. There is nothing wrong, and I'm yet to find a single thing that doesn't work with my personal van. And I'm really, really excited about that, because whenever I had a cooler before, I was noticing that on a hot day like today, I would come out and I would have a sloshy mess. It was disgusting, guys. I couldn't keep anything cold for very long, even in a really nice cooler, because the heat would just melt the stuff down and it would cause a slosh. Now, that doesn't work whenever you're on the road for many, many days and nowhere near a store. So I really needed something like this that I wouldn't have to worry about the sloshy, nasty, gross ice getting everywhere. And whenever I was able to use this, that opened up a whole new world to me of being able to have fresh fruits and veggies, eggs, which I never trusted really in a cooler before, milk, stuff like that. And now I can eat much better while I'm on the road, instead of having to always be kind of like, oh, is this gonna keep? Now, I know in my initial no build van build video, which by the way, link is in the description below, many of you had recommended that I go ahead and pull the trigger on getting something like this. And wow, oh wow, I can see why now. It is so useful, so helpful, and it fits perfectly right behind my driver's seat. And I think that was one of my concerns, that it was going to be too big or that it would pull too much power. And well, you never know unless you try. And I'm glad that I did, because otherwise I wouldn't know. And now I do. And now I don't see myself doing van life any other way. So to wrap up the review, would I recommend the SetPower? Absolutely, I would. Again, they do have other sizes available. So if you need something smaller, they have it. If you want something larger, they have it. And if you're looking for something as a backup at your house, they have ones that would work for that too. I can set this up at the house whenever I'm at home base and actually keep things in here. I can keep it in case of an emergency, like the power goes out, I can put things in it and hook it up to my Jackery. There's so many options with this. And again, I do highly recommend it.